This is the founder of Rockstar Games in 2009. This is him last week in 2020. So recently these photos surfaced of Sam and whoa, this man is not looking his age. For a 49-year-old, he's looking a bit tired, but hey, I guess that's what GTA Online will do to you. So if the founder of Grand Theft Auto could go from this to this, I figured let's take a look at some of the most popular Grand Theft Auto characters back in their respective games, and it's mainly just protagonists, but let's see what they look like now based on their real-life inspirations. I've also hidden three CJs in this video. If you can find all three CJs and send me screenshot proof, I've got a surprise for you. Also, if you enjoy, please click thumbs up and subscribe for more content like this. Number 11, Claude. Yeah, I'm serious about this one. While Claude Speed from Grand Theft Auto 2 and Claude from Grand Theft Auto 3 are two different characters because of the different GTA universes, well, they actually share many similarities. So for this video, we're going to combine the two. So when Grand Theft Auto 2 released, it also came with an 8-minute promo movie that I can't actually show because of stupid copyright issues. But I can show images. So in this movie, Claude is portrayed by Scott Maslin, who in real life was born in 1971. So based on that, that would make Claude 21 during GTA San Andreas and 30 during Grand Theft Auto 3. Oh, and did you know that Claude never actually had an official name until his cameo in Grand Theft Auto San Andreas that actually released 3 years after GTA 3, but takes place 9 years before? Yeah, confusing sometimes, I know. Anyways, what's he up to now and what would he look like? Well, he would actually be 49 years old, and if you ask me, this dude is a stud. Claude definitely evolved. I just wonder if he ever found his voice. Number 10, Tommy Vercetti. Born in June 1951, Tommy Vercetti is 35 years old during the events of GTA Vice City in 1986. Tommy is voiced by and based loosely on Ray Liotta, probably the most famous of all GTA protagonist actors. He was a world-renowned actor before landing his role as Tommy Vercetti, and this was actually back during a time where video games were almost looked down upon in the acting world, as movies and actors made way more than games back then, so these guys just thought they were better. Now it's actually the reverse. But because of this, however, other actors who worked on GTA Vice City claimed that Ray Liotta wasn't a very pleasant person to work around, and that he thought he was better than everyone. So, what's Tommy up to nowadays? Well, as of 2020, Tommy is now 69 years old, and occasionally makes cameos in commercials for Chantix. Now, there's actually a few different mods and concepts out there that give us a better look at what Tommy might look like in-game. The first being a Weasel news report claiming that Tommy is 55 years old and he's returning. This would imply that this would be in the year 2006 if Tommy was 55. Next, we have a pretty cool mod from Grand Theft Auto 4 that also shows us Tommy with short white hair and sporting a beard. And if this were true, and in 2008, that would make Tommy 57 years old. Number 9, Carl Johnson. Born in 1968, CJ was only 24 during the events of Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, making him one of the youngest protagonists in Grand Theft Auto history. CJ is portrayed by Christopher Bellard, better known by his stage name Young Melee, who happens to be a rapper. Did you know that Young Melee landed his role as CJ by accident? Basically, DJ Pooh was in a meeting with Rockstar Games when he got a call from a good buddy of his, and when he answered, he just so happened to have the caller on speakerphone, and that caller was Young Melee. Rockstar liked the sound of his voice so much that they booked him a recording session on the spot, and the rest is history. So, what's CJ up to today? Well, aside from taking jabs at Rockstar Games on Instagram live videos and wanting to beat up Nico Bellic, he's still pursuing his rap career. Or, if you missed my documentary-style video from just a few days ago, CJ is hiding away, enjoying his millions. Number 8, Tony Cipriani. So, when it comes to Tony, there really isn't much of a comparison to make with his actor, so instead, we're just gonna show how much Tony changed from 1998 in Liberty City Stories to 2001 during Grand Theft Auto 3. Woof. Number 7, Victor Vance. So, in case you didn't know, Vic Vance was gunned down in the introduction to GTA Vice City. So, during the events of Vice City Stories, he's 28 years old. That makes him 30 during Vice City. And, well, this is Victor Vance and what he looks like today. Number 6, Nico Bellic. Man, I must be getting old, because to me, it's strange to think that my favorite GTA protagonist was only 6 years older than I currently am when he made his debut in Grand Theft Auto 4. Nico was 30 years old and born in 1978. What's cool about Nico, though, is his real-life inspiration. Based on a character named Sasha from the 2001 movie Behind Enemy Lines, you can actually unlock in Grand Theft Auto 4 the outfit from this movie as an Easter egg. The role of Nico was actually offered to Vladimir Mashkov initially, the actor of Sasha, but he politely turned it down as he thought the role sounded super questionable when asked to play a man with a dark past with a slightly rumpled appearance in an unnamed video game. See, I'm telling y'all, back then, actors thought they were better than gamers. He sure missed out there. So in 2020, Nico would only be 42 years old, super young. But what would he look like? Well, if we base it off of his inspiration, Vladimir Mashkov, then Nico would be looking like an older, dried up Chris D'Elia and really showing signs of his age. We've also got a couple cool concepts of an older Nico Bellic, and personally, I think they made him about 20 years too old, so maybe we'll return in 2040 and see if he looks like this. Number 5, Johnny Clements. Born in 1974, Johnny is 34 during the events of Grand Theft Auto 4 and its episodes from Liberty City. And after migrating out to Sandy Shores sometime between 2008 and 2013, Johnny meets his maker. And just like Victor Vance, this is Johnny Clements in 2020. Number 4, Luis Lopez. So, it sucks that we haven't seen or heard from Luis since 2009. Hopefully, he's doing pretty well. But back then, Luis Lopez was 25 years old and born in 1983. But if we actually take a look at Luis's voice actor and see what he looks like in 2020, then we could maybe get an idea of what Luis would look like as he would now be 37 years old. Number 3, Franklin Clinton. So, while he was the youngest of the Grand Theft Auto 5 trio, born in 1988 in-game, Franklin was only 24 during the events of Grand Theft Auto 5. So, in 2020, he'd only be 32 years old. However, in real life, Franklin's actor Sean Fontino is 52 years old, the same age as CJ and Tony Cipriani would be if they were real-life people. He's aging gracefully and seems to be enjoying his life, embracing the successes of Grand Theft Auto 5. Number 2, Michael DeSanta. Middle-aged and slightly overweight, Michael is 45 during Grand Theft Auto 5 in 2013 and 36 during the prologue, which takes place in 2004. It seems like Rockstar has an obsession with GTA characters being born in 1968 because, just like CJ and Tony, Michael would be the same age as them in 2020, coming in at a whopping 52 years young. But if we base his looks and everything off of his real-life counterpart, Ned Luke, Michael would actually be 62 years old in 2020 and aging like fine wine and sitting back enjoying the successes of Grand Theft Auto 5, just like Franklin. And number 1, Trevor Phillips. So, did you know that Trevor is actually the oldest of the GTA 5 trio and that he's Canadian? Born in 1965, Trevor is 39 during the prologue in 2004 and 48 during the events of GTA 5 in 2013. Dang, Trevor is old as dirt. That would make him 55 in real life right now. That's super crazy to think about. If that was the case, he'd probably be looking like this. Not even kidding. That's Trevor's real-life inspiration, Stephen Ogg, who, ironically, in real life, out of the GTA 5 trio, is actually the youngest at 47 years old currently, compared to Ned Luke, who is 62, and Sean Fontino, who is 52. Trevor's actor, Stephen Ogg, is a ridiculously handsome man and aging insanely well. Not to mention that he's in amazing shape. So, as far as Trevor goes, when it comes to what he's up to, he's aging well and he's probably still running the streets of Sandy Shores. Anyways, that is some of our favorite GTA protagonists and what they're up to now in 2020. If you enjoyed this video, please click thumbs up and subscribe with notifications turned on. My channel is dying and it's really depressing. So if y'all enjoy, I hope you want to stick around for more. Click the video on the screen to watch some more of my content. And as always, my name is Zach Cox, and I'll catch y'all on the flip side.